Okay, let's try to go to LAX. A lot less to talk about on this drive than the last nighttime rainy ones that I did. Sorry, I'm kind of quiet. Probably better to not listen to me and listen to some Beastie Boys.
towards all terminals. Now take the ramp on the right toward LAX Airport, all terminals. In 500 feet, keep left toward departing flights. Keep left toward departing flights.
It's stopping for no reason here. I'm gonna give it some gas. Just... Oh, it seemed like it is going to arriving flights. We want to get up here into this mess. Navigation error. How many disengagements will we have? This is way busier than the last time that I was here, and it did okay last time. Yeah, let's see how it does. Confidence about getting through this situation without any air, so I'm covering the pedals and I have both hands on the wheel, a little more attentive than normal here. I'm gonna do my best to not tell it where to go or how to move around these lanes and just see what it does. So far, this is not much more challenging than just some stop and go traffic. I'm gonna change the routing now in just a minute to route me back home so we don't get to an end of navigation rated, a complicated situation back here. Hitting the gas pedal because this bus behind me is trying to get in. I'm gonna switch this to assertive, see what that helps us have a little more fun here. I'm not sure what this dark line is here that's kind of wiggling between the vehicles here. That seems new. Maybe that's where it plans on stopping.
In 500 feet, turn left onto West Way.
No, we're not going to do that. Let's let it go a little bit further. I don't know why it's barking at me. I have my hand on the wheel and I'm looking at the road. Let's try one more time. Nope, we got to wait. Let's let it get past that little turn. This car on our left is trying to get over quite aggressively. I'm gonna stop so this van can get out. I don't want to be super rude. We're gonna keep trying to go anyway. Not being very polite. This is fun. This guy likes to go backward down the road. The car, if it knew we were trying to go all the way through here, it really should be getting into another lane, but this struggle is a little more interesting. Maybe we'll learn a little more. So many bad decisions. I am not going to also let this car to our right go if they try to get in. I did a little gas pedal there. Another little gas pedal. Look at this. So stupid. These people are so mean. I'm doing more gas pedal just because I don't want to be here all day. I'm not doing any inputs anymore. Okay, now we can tell this thing to take us. What will it tell you? Take us back somewhere more useful. Here's the check-in guy. So I'm going to change that one more time. Turn signal on this bus. I think it's just stationary. I'm good. We're stopping for this crosswalk like we should. I unnecessary braking there. I don't know what that was, but it swerved to the left suddenly. The car should really roll up a little bit. I'm gonna nudge it forward a little. Crosswalk right here. Okay, good. We got a turn signal on. It seems like we do need to start getting over soon. The car really should be trying to get into the other lanes. They're going to be a lot faster than this one. I'm pushing the gas pedal. And again with the gas pedal. Gas pedal again. have 0.4 miles till we do a left turn. I think we need to be in the farthest left lane to do that. So we have two lane changes to do in 0.4 miles, I believe. The lane next to us is clear. It could be merging right now if it wanted to. But I'm gonna just let it try to do what it wants to do and see where it fails. We really are quite far away from this car in front of us. Like, a whole car could probably fit between us. The car should be scooted up significantly closer. Gas pedal again. Scooting over to give those people a little bit of room on the right. Still no turn signal. We got 0.3 miles now. Go probably now. It'd be nice if it was being a little more clear about letting this Lexus in. Okay, it's hitting the brakes when it should be catching back up. Get over, the lane's clear. It makes me anxious that it's not going. Now it taps the turn signal right when a car is approaching the blind spot. There's a car coming up behind us on the left lane again, but after that it's clear for a moment. It could go now. Not even gonna try. Could go now. It's wide open. It's kind of bad behavior, in my opinion, to wait till the last second like this to try to merge in these busy places. Like, it could go now again. There's just tons of opportunity. Also, we would be getting to our destination a little quicker if it got over. I wonder if I was in chill mode, if it would have changed lanes further back. One mile now, left turn. I can go after this blue car. Okay, that was pretty good.
In 500 feet, keep left to take roadway toward California 1 North, Sepulveda Boulevard.
Okay, we do need to be in the left lane now. Alright, well, I guess it made it over into the lane. Wasn't,
Now keep left to take
I don't know, way. As anxiety-free as I would rather be in the lane sooner and take the more relaxed opportunities for merges.
Now keep left to take roadway.
It's got the speed limit at 25 here, but it's a little slow.
In 500 feet, bear left to stay on roadway.
Here's Siren.
Bear left to stay on roadway.
Or maybe not. And we have like tons of room between the car. I'm gonna roll it up a little bit. Trying to set an appropriate distance to the car in front of me. Alright, temporarily unavailable. Maybe it's because we're so close to this car in front of us. I don't know. I can still almost see their tires touching the ground from my perspective. Like, the camera is a little lower than my eye line. Okay, green light. Let's see here. I'm available still. There we go. Wants to get in the other lane, which it should. Yeah, I'm giving it some gas. We can't be having this kind of shenanigans at the front of an intersection like this. And now it wants to get back to the left. I'm canceling this turn signal. I don't want to be confusing any more than I already am to people. Need to be going right anyway, so I'm not quite sure why it wants to keep putting the left turn signal on. There's the correct turn signal. I don't know what the honking is about. Nobody seems to be doing anything weird. I think we have two merges we need to do to the right to get our exit in, like, I don't know, 1,000 feet. And the car could have set itself up a lot better for this. Okay, I'm taking over. This is not aggressive enough. Okay. Sorry if you wanted to see the car try to do that on its own. I'm pretty confident it would not have made it over to this exit. And again, we're stopped way too far away from this car in front of us. I guess we get a green light. Lane to the left. There's a car. it's a little closer. I would speed up if this were me, but the car is slowing down. Turned off its turn signal. It's gonna have to go now. Yep, good. Go 40 miles an hour here. This is not, it's like a 50 mile an hour zone, I think. Route. I think my summary here is speed still seems to be a challenge. Like, it doesn't quite know what to do for setting the speed. Also, like, right now we're getting some weird slowdowns for no reason. But, so if it was able to figure out the speed more appropriately, I think the only other challenge that we really saw was if there are like three or more maneuvers in rapid succession, like within a few hundred meters of each other, doesn't seem to plan ahead very well which lane it should be in, so it ends up, like, after a couple turns getting into situations maybe where it's challenging to get to the lane it needs to be in. But, and we only have done this once, so it could be a one-off thing we observed here. Maybe it'll do great the rest of the time, but yeah, it seems like it would benefit from being able to think maybe three or four maneuvers ahead and which lanes are best in to do that. We're in a lane here now where parking is allowed, so we're going to come up on parked cars right after this stoplight. It'd be interesting to see how it does this. Slowing down and turn signal. Yeah. Alright, well, the lane change through the intersection there is not ideal, but I don't know what else you would do around here with this parking situation. Well, we had a couple disengagements, yeah, some speed issues, some lane selection issues, but it didn't really do anything that put the car or anybody else at risk. It was safe. It's definitely better and better each time, I think. Well, hopefully there's something interesting in here for you to see or to learn about. Yeah, let me know what you think.